to determine the current flowing through the diode and the voltage drop across the emitter collector terminals, we need to find the emitter and collector currents. So let's start with writing a KVL, Kirchhoff voltage law, from the supply voltage, voltage drop across the diode, emitter base terminals, and the base resistor. Solving the KVL equation will give us the base current value. With knowing the base current IAB, we can calculate the collector and emitter currents. Here, assuming the diode is forward bias, we can calculate the current flowing through the resistor RAE. So the current IRE will be the voltage drop across the diode, which is in parallel with the resistor RE, divided by RAE. Now by writing a KCL for the emitter node, we can determine the current flowing through the diode. Basically, here the KCL equation says that the total currents entering to the emitter node equals the current leaving the node. Solving this equation will provide us with the diode current IID. By the way, if you like what you are watching, please hit the like and bell buttons and also subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet. Now back to the video. To determine the emitter collector voltage, first we need to find the voltage at the emitter and collector terminals respect to the common ground. The voltage at the collector can be determined by multiplying the collector current by the collector resistor RC. And the voltage at the emitter terminal will be the supply voltage minus the voltage drop across the diode. The voltage drop at the emitter collector terminals will be the emitter voltage minus the collector voltage. As you can see here, this voltage is greater than 0.2 volt, which is the emitter collector saturation voltage. So the result is acceptable. I have other videos in reviewing BJT circuit at DC, which I will put the links under the video description.